Let's look at what happens when a lossless transmission line is used to drive a load located at Z equals L. Suppose we input a signal here. The signal will have voltage to current ratio fixed by Z0, the characteristic impedance. However, at the end of the line, we know that the total voltage and total current must conform to Ohm's law. Total voltage divided by total current equals ZL, the load impedance. If Z0 and ZL are equal, then the ratio of forward voltage to forward current is equal to the ratio of total voltage to total current, and this works out perfectly. The total voltage is just a forward voltage wave, the total current is just the forward current wave, and the entire signal is transferred to the load. However, if Z0 and ZL are not equal, then the ratio of forward voltage to forward current is not equal to the ratio of total voltage to total current. How do we make sense of that? Remember, the total voltage consists of both our input wave, V0 plus, and a possible backward wave, V0 minus. Similarly, the total current consists of both the input wave, I0 plus, and a possible backward wave. If Z0 is not equal to ZL, the load is not matched to the line, and this mismatch will result in a reflection at the load. The reflected portion of the signal will propagate back toward the source as a backward wave. In the case of a mismatched load, then, we will have both a forward propagating wave and a backward propagating wave on the line. But how much of the wave will be reflected? To figure that out, let's look at the relationships we already know. Firstly, the load impedance sets the ratio of total voltage to total current, which is given here. The line impedance, Z0, sets the ratio of forward voltage to forward current, and also the ratio of backward voltage to backward current. We can combine and rearrange these equations to show that the ratio of reflected voltage to input voltage is given here. And if we let the location of the load be the zero location for the z-axis, or in other words, if we let L equal zero, this simplifies to this equation, which we will use as the definition for capital gamma, the reflection coefficient. So, if you wish to calculate the magnitude of the reflected voltage wave, you can just multiply the magnitude of the input voltage wave by gamma. So consider this scenario. A transmission line with characteristic impedance Z0 is terminated with load impedance of ZL. A signal V0 plus is input to the system and travels down the line until it reaches the load. At the load, a portion of the wave is reflected according to gamma times the magnitude of the input voltage. The remainder of the signal is absorbed by the load. So to maximize energy transfer to the load, we want to minimize gamma, which means getting ZL as close to Z0 as possible. Let's look at three special cases here. First, suppose ZL equals Z0. In this case, you have a perfect match. Gamma equals zero, nothing is reflected, and all the signal flows into the load. Second, suppose ZL is infinite. This is the open circuit scenario. Here, gamma equals one, and all the signal reflects back toward the source with nothing absorbed by the load. Finally, suppose ZL is zero. This is the short circuit scenario. Here, gamma equals negative one, indicating that the entire signal reflects back toward the load with a phase shift of 180 degrees. Like in the open circuit case, nothing is absorbed by the load. Note that on a lossless line, the characteristic impedance is positive and purely real. In this case, as long as the load is passive, gamma will have a magnitude between 0 and 1. We will also define the standing wave ratio, or SWR, as 1 plus the magnitude of gamma over 1 minus the magnitude of gamma. And we will define return loss, or RL, as negative 20 log base 10 of the magnitude of gamma. Note that gamma, SWR, and RL are all just alternative ways of talking about the reflection.